Hello and welcome to Elimu Television. This is a series of educational programs we are airing in the whole of Kenya, covering the various subjects in the Kenyan school curriculum. This is CRE Form 2. My name is Miss Karihe. We have just completed the Form 1 syllabus. We have covered the Old Testament and African religious heritage. In Form 2's work, we are mainly going to look at Christian witness, and we will deal with one gospel, the St. Luke's Gospel, which is one of the books in the New Testament under the category of the biographical books. The Luke's Gospel gives us an autobiography of the life history of Jesus. Luke tried to give a vivid awareness of the birth, the life, and ministry of Jesus. Welcome. Let us start by first looking at various definitions. We'll start with the word Messiah. The word Messiah comes from a Hebrew word, Messiah, which means the anointed one. In the Old Testament, it refers to kings and priests who are chosen to serve God. For example, God commanded Moses to anoint the sons of Aaron by pouring olive oil on them so that they may serve me as priests. That is in Exodus 28, verse 41. Prophets in the Old Testament were also anointed by the Spirit of God to serve him. Therefore, kings, priests, and prophets were anointed by God to serve him for various specific tasks. A Messiah, therefore, means someone called, anointed, and appointed by God for specific tasks, to serve him in a special way. The second definition is the term prophecy. Prophecy refers to a prediction of what will happen in the future. Messianic prophecies are therefore those predictions that were made by the prophets to describe a righteous king who would rule Israel according to God's will. We will start with our first prophecy in the Old Testament that predicts the coming of the Messiah. And we'll begin with Nathan's prophecy. We are going to get this prophecy of Nathan by reading 2 Samuel chapter 7, verse 3 to 17. Nathan's prophecy is the most important prophecy because it forms the origin of all other messianic prophecies about the Messiah. All other prophets who predicted about the coming of the Messiah lay their basis or their foundation on Nathan's prophecy. Now it is divided into three. A, it is where God warns David of building a temple or a house for him. David had just completed building himself a beautiful palace made of cedar, and he thought it was not right for the Ark of the Covenant, the special wooden box that contained the two stone tablets on which the Ten Commandments were written, to be carried in. He thought it was important for the Ark of the Covenant to be housed in a permanent temple, because earlier on, the Ark of the Covenant was housed in a tabernacle, which was a temporary temple. But in this case, we see God stopping David from the idea of building him a palace, and he says that he cannot be limited in a house built by human hands. The second part of the prophecy of Nathan, it says that it was necessary for a temple to be built for God. God told David that one of his sons would build a temple for him. Can you recall from your Form 1 work who built the temple at Jerusalem for God? The third prophecy, and the most important, is the one that tells David that his kingdom will be established forever and it will be blessed. In quotes, "Your house shall be made sure forever. Your kingdom will have no end." Now, from Nathan's prophecy, we can deduce the following. One, an heir will be raised from David's house to sit on the throne. Two, God will ensure that his kingdom will last forever. Three, God will make sure that Israel will be saved from her enemies and they will live in peace. Four, God will support such a king. Five, God will keep David's kingdom strong for his sons. Six, David's name will be made great or famous. Seven, God will give Israel their own land. Now, this kingdom promised to David has two meanings. The first meaning is that it could refer to an earthly kingdom. The kingdom of David can be seen to have been everlasting in the sense that David's kingdom ruled Israel for a period of 400 years. The dynasty of David lasted 400 years. All the kings who ruled Israel for the 400 years were direct descendants of King David. We also see that Solomon built the temple for God. We can also say that the kingdom of David lasted the 400 years until it was destroyed by the Babylonians in 587 BC. That is 587 years before Christ was born. The second part of David's prophecy of an everlasting kingdom is fulfilled with the life and ministry of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ was a direct descendant of King David because his foster father Joseph was a descendant of King David. And that is the spiritual kingdom that was promised to David. That ends our lesson for today. In the next lesson, we'll look at Isaiah's prophecy about the Messiah. But for your homework today, I would want you to answer the following questions. One, outline the promises that were made to David by God through Prophet Nathan. Your reference is 2 Samuel chapter 7, verse 3 to 17. Second question, explain how Jesus fulfilled Nathan's prophecy about the Messiah. I have been your teacher, Madam Karihe. Until next time, bye-bye.